After a terrifying ordeal, survivors are led to safety. It was a full house at the historic Paris concert hall, the Bataclan, for a performance by the US rock band, the Eagles of Death Metal. Witnesses say gunfire rang out in the middle of the concert, but it took a few moments before the band and the crowd realised what was happening. Survivors described scenes of carnage that left scores dead.
We managed to escape through a door that was right on the stage, and we hid there for 2 hours. 25 people in a room, all stacked, one against the other, crouching and hearing Kalashnikov shots. It was as if people were being tortured. They were hurt because they were being shot.
There were blasts coming from everywhere. We tried escaping and then we ended up in front of the guy, but he didn't shoot us, so we were able to escape.
After a standoff of several hours, police managed to clear the building when the assailants detonated suicide bombs.
The terrorists who had barricaded themselves in upstairs blew themselves up. They had explosives strapped to themselves. There were 4 dead during the operation to take the building under control.
It was one of a series of attacks in the east of Paris during the night. Several cafe terraces were strafed with machine gun fire. One was a popular Cambodian restaurant in the 10th arrondissement. A France 24 journalist was dining there when the attack occurred.
We were sitting right at the window when there was numerous gunshots directed at the window towards the restaurant that we were eating in. We immediately dropped to the floor with all the other diners, and we were there for maybe one minute, lying on the floor, as we continued to hear numerous gunshots. I noticed the woman next to me had a fatal injury.
Multiple explosions were also heard further north outside the Stade de France during the France-Germany friendly international. President François Hollande was at the match, but he was promptly rushed to the Interior Ministry for an emergency cabinet meeting. He also visited the scenes of the attacks.
Lots of people have been wounded, seriously wounded, and who are in a state of shock from what they have witnessed. So we wanted to come here to be among those who have seen these horrible things.
The president also declared a state of emergency, which includes closing France's borders. The shootings come 10 months after 17 people were killed in multiple terrorist attacks in Paris last January.